Hello all, my name is Sage, and today we're going to be continuing on with Mega Man Zero. It's been a while, admittedly, but I kind of just needed a break. I know I usually say that, but it's pretty demotivating to make content sometimes. Not necessarily because I'm a small creator, but I don't know. It's just like hard to like really care that much when you're like, I don't know. It's hard to describe. I've been playing new stuff, enjoying my spare time after work, so I do definitely want to continue on with this and Lufia 2, so while the uploads may be like really fucking slow, I do plan on finishing this stuff, so just keep that in mind. So last time we left off, we did the train mission, which went pretty well. This time we're doing retrieve data, which all of these, I just want to say for reference, all of these missions are like, they all have like, well, some of them have side objectives, not all of them, but they're basically like Mega Man X levels with extra steps for the most part. Like, you're still gonna fight a boss at the end of most of them. Okay, I'm terrible, it seems. Okay, yeah. This is not a good start. Luckily, there are a good amount of enemies to bully for health. So, I'm not too worried. But there is a bomb here. God damn it. Okay. At this point, I'm just being a bit too careless. There we go. There we go. And here we have our next boss. I would recommend charging both weapons up if possible. And definitely having the weakness, because this boss is a pain in the ass. So essentially, he's like an elephant guy with an Ida Honda style attack. But he also has, oh wow, I fucked that up, a bit of a different style. He can also basically like spin dash, as you can see there. Ow. Fuck you. There we go. He actually wasn't too bad there, but he can throw projectiles and spin dashes, and luckily I was like really close to the corner, so it wasn't really that big of a deal, but yeah, now we triggered this event, which without the rolling slash, you're going to be in a load of trouble, so do that, because I'm extremely fast. And I didn't mention it, but if you do this, you do lose access to this area, which can hamper your grinding, so keep that in mind. Luckily, it shouldn't be too big of a deal at this point. There we go. We completely own that mission, in my opinion. And we got an 89. Pretty good. And yeah, that data was completely worthless, but we do get a new weapon out of this, which is pretty nice. So let's go get that from Servo. And it is the Triple Rod, which is a very I would say it's a pretty underrated weapon. I think for more advanced players, it's like not, it's not too underrated. Like they utilize it a lot, because when you level it up, it can like go up two more stages, which gives it a lot of range. Let me go outside, and you can also angle it up diagonally. So it's really good for hitting enemies that are off-screen, especially aerial ones, which are like really annoying because of the screen crunch of the GBA games. So that's just something to keep in mind. I'm going to level it up off-screen because it can take forever. So I'll see you then. The usual spot, since the data part is down, even though I don't use it, they're basically those respawning spiders you can farm in the data segment. But basically, I'm just going to use the respawning tower enemies that I always do. And I'll see you then. And we're back. Before we go to the next mission, I do want to show off the weapon. So like I was saying, it extends up pretty damn far, and you can also charge it for kind of like this spinning attack, which covers a pretty good range. I think if in this game, for some reason, like even though it's a charge attack, if you do that into something else, it'll count as like priority over the other attacks, which is pretty weird. It's the opposite in the next game. Not that this exact weapon is in the next game, but there's something very similar. If that's a spoiler, I guess. My bad. So, now we're going to go on to the next level. It's probably going to be the last one for this video. Occupy Factory. So this one is a bit harder than the other ones. Like, you can pretty easily die in this one. So, just a heads up. But we mainly want to come here for a specific reason. There we go. We want to come here for a specific... Fuck you. A specific reason. Not doing so good yet. There we go. The boss drops the fire chip, which is gonna be very helpful in the next mission we're going to be doing, so just a heads up for why we're doing this stage order that we're doing. No health drop, so I'm gonna cry. There we go. It's always, like, nice to do that for enemies, because you do get extra rank for doing that, for killing more enemies, of course. So this part is kind of stressful, but honestly, I'm going to equip the Buster. That's the weapon of choice here. To shoot those damn spiders. Oh no, I fucked up the jump. Okay. So yeah, as you can see, I'm going to cut back to where I was, because that's, you know, one of the main reasons I was saying this level can be pretty hard, but you should get it after one or two tries, so I'll see you then. So we're back, and basically you just want to do nothing. And then go up these ladders. Yeah, it's really just out of one area, that's kind of a dick move, but other than that, you should be fine. I'm gonna get this health, because... Wow. I'm actually surprised I didn't get hit there. But yeah, I do want to be at full health for this next part. I do think they give you a health drop here, or not. Maybe it's because I entered here with full health, but... Now this next boss can be pretty rough if you don't know what you're doing. Or just in general. So he shoots turrets, which can cancel your attacks, really annoying. But you can get 3 charge sabers in there. There we go. The ice one is really easy to avoid. There we go. So yeah, pretty easy boss if you have the charge slash, which hopefully you do at this point. That's the only way to abuse weaknesses, and otherwise, you gotta deal with these bosses that are like incredibly hard to combo, and you can't really hit them. You can't really combo them because they're like, as you can see, that guy was flying, and the elephant guy is just like too big to reliably charge slash because his hurtbox is on his head. But we do get access to another weapon before I end the video. I'm going to level it up off screen because it's still going to take a bit, but basically. The Shield Boomerang. This weapon is kind of underrated, mainly for casual players, or like players who like are new to the game, because they just stick with the Saber and the Buster, which are admittedly like really good, but they sleep on the Triple Rod and the Shield Boomerang. But as you can see here, if you charge it up, it'll like hover around you. And as long as you, like, loop it, and, like, keep moving forward, too, it's really good because it's, like, an active hitbox that keeps hitting the opponent. And you can also stack it with weaknesses and do it versus bosses. Like, you can hit them and then have the Shield Boomerang hit them at the same time, and you get, like, disgusting damage output. And even if you don't use the charge attack, this reflects projectiles, although that's... admittedly not very useful, and that's why a lot of people don't really like that weapon. But overall, it's pretty good for what you can do if you, like, explore your options a bit. I wouldn't really rank the weapons. It's probably, like, more important on hard mode because the Triple Rod and the Shield Boomerang become, like, a lot... well... I don't know, because you can't use charge moves in hard mode. So I'd probably say the Triple Rod becomes the best weapon by far. But yeah, I just wanted to go over those weapons a bit before I ended the video. And as you can see, you can attack diagonally, which is really good. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.